John Gill, 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 5. Reading from the King James Bible, first quote, "Not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles, which know not God," unquote. John Gill, quote, "Not in the lust of concupiscence, or passion of lust, for the mere gratifying and indulging of that. For a man so to possess his vessel is to cherish the sin of concupiscence, the first motions of sin in his heart, by which a man is drawn away and enticed to blow up the flame of lust and to make provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. Even as the Gentiles which know not God, for though they knew him, or might know him with a natural knowledge by the light and works of nature, yet they knew him not savingly and spiritually, but as he is revealed in the word, of which they were destitute, or as the God of all grace, and the God and Father of Christ, or as he is in Christ, and though by the light of nature they might know there was a God, yet they knew not who that God was, nor did they act up to that light and knowledge they had. They did not glorify him as God by ascribing to him what was his due, nor were they thankful for the mercies they received from him, nor did they fear, love, worship, and serve him, nor did they like to retain him in their knowledge, and therefore were given up to judicial blindness and hardness, to reprobate mind into a vile affection, and so did things very inconvenient, unnatural, and dishonorable. Wherefore, for a man to use either his wife or his body in an unchaste and dishonorable manner for the gratifying of his lust is to act in a heathenish part. A like argument, dissuading from things unlawful, is used in Matthew chapter 6, verse 32, unquote. Scripture, quote, "Not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God," unquote. End of John Gill, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 5.